Hi, my name is Heather Francisco, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi Associates, and I will be discussing the topic of discounting. Discounting occurs when the subjective value of an outcome changes because its delivery is delayed or uncertain. Discounting is when rewards lose their value. This video will focus on delayed discounting. The rate of delayed discounting is how fast a reward loses its value over time. Discounting has a significant impact on choice making. For example, a nicotine-deprived smoker may highly value a cigarette and would be motivated to get one in the next 6 hours. In contrast, that same smoker would assign no value and do little to obtain a cigarette available in 6 months from now. When making a decision, one may or may not forgo small immediate rewards in order to obtain larger rewards in the future. This can manifest in many of our decisions. One might study for his exam that is next Friday, or go out with his friends tonight. One might try to obtain a healthy weight by eating foods low in calories, or eat a piece of chocolate cake at a friend's birthday party. Another might save a certain amount of money to buy a car in 6 months, or buy jewelry for a dance that is tomorrow. People have a tendency to discount how valuable a reward is when that reward is increasingly further in the future. Behavior analysts describe impulsivity as the likelihood that one would choose the smaller sooner reward over the larger later reward. Inversely, self-control is the likelihood that one would wait for the larger later reward. When a person demonstrates that they have high self-control, they are considered shallow discounters. And when a person demonstrates they are impulsive, they are considered steep discounters. The Stanford Marshmallow experiment was a series of well-known studies on delayed gratification in the late 1960s and early 1970s led by psychologist Walter Mischel. A child was offered a choice between one small reward provided immediately or two small rewards contingent on waiting for a short period of time. For approximately 15 minutes, the tester left the room and the participants waited for them to return. The researchers then observed participants' behavior during that 15 minutes and noted which participants could wait for the delayed reward of two treats. The reward was sometimes a marshmallow, but often a cookie or pretzel, depending on the participant's preference. The study sought to determine variability in choice making and self-control among preschoolers. It also had implications for measuring delay discounting. Delay discounting procedures are about finding the point at which two rewards, one relatively immediate and one delayed, have approximately the same value. This is known as the indifference point. In assessing how delay affects the value of outcomes with humans, researchers commonly ask people to make a series of choices between hypothetical options, rather than giving them the consequences associated with each choice. For example, Rachlin, Ranieri, and Cross in 1991 asked college students to choose between $1,000 available today and $1,000 available in a month. The amount of the immediate option decreased across trials until it reached $1. Then it increased back up to $1,000. The indifference point was the average amount at which the participants switched the preference for the small sooner reward or the later larger reward. So for example, a participant would prefer $1,000 today over $1,000 in a month, but then at about $960 today might switch to choosing the delayed option of $1,000 through the rest of the trials as the immediate amount continued to decrease. When the immediate amount then increased across trials, the participant would initially prefer the delayed $1,000, but then perhaps at $940 would switch to choosing the immediate amount again. In this particular example, the indifference point would be, on average, $950. In general, the indifference points decreased as the delay to the larger amount increased. This is the empirical demonstration of delayed discounting. The value of money is degraded systematically as the money becomes more remote or further in the future. Mazur, in 1987, evaluated several different possible quantitative models to describe the indifference points as a function of delay and determined that the following equation provided the best fit. The hyperbolic equation states that the present value of a reward, known as V, is equal to the amount or magnitude of the reward, known as M or A, divided by the delay of the reward, D. The numeral 1 appears in the denominator of the equation to prevent present value from approaching infinity as the delay approaches 0. The delay, D, is then multiplied by a scaling factor, K, which describes how much value is affected by delay. If K is relatively large, then the effect of the delay on degrading value is bigger than if K is small. As the empirically derived discounting K value increases, the discounted value V decreases more quickly as a function of the delay. In other words, the larger the degree of discounting, the quicker the value decreases over time. The hyperbolic equation can be broken down as follows. V equals A divided by 1 plus K divided by D. V equals the subjective value. A, or M, is the amount or magnitude of the reward. K is the sensitivity to change in delay or the value of discounting. And D is the length of the delay. According to Kaplan in 2016, one efficient approach to obtaining a human subject's rate of delay discounting is via the 21 and 27 item monetary choice questionnaire. This consists of choice tasks that assess preference between small immediate and large delayed monetary outcomes. Unfortunately, the scoring procedures for the questionnaire are rather complex, which may serve as a barrier to their use. This report details a freely available Excel-based spreadsheet tool that automatically scores momentary choice questionnaires and response sets. When participants scored a zero, it suggests that they would take the monetary reward as opposed to the larger later reward after the specified delay. Delay length varied per trial. When participants scored a one, it suggests that they would wait for the specified delay for the larger monetary reward. More zeros and less ones indicate steep discounting, and less zeros and more ones indicate shallow delay discounting. More to come on discounting, stay tuned. References are cited beneath the video. Feel free to post questions or comments below.